Welcome back. In this video, we are going to set up the SASS environment, and this is to make sure that we have the correct environment for working with SASS. So the first one is to install Node.js. It's an open source server environment. Node.js allows you to run JavaScript on the server, and it's free and it runs on various platforms. So if your machine is not yet installed with Node.js, you can head over to the official website, which is nodejs.org. So here on the homepage, for those who are using Windows, we have a download recommended for most users, and this one is more than enough for this project. Alternatively, you can also download the current one, which has the latest features. For other platforms like Linux and Mac, you can check on this link that says downloads. So here you need to download the one compatible with your platform or operating system, and then once you download, then you can install it on your machine. And once you install, then you need to open your terminal and run node minus minus version. And this command will enable you to confirm whether your machine is installed with Node.js. Alternatively, you can also use node minus v. So you can see mine is installed with version 15.50. It can be different in your case, but make sure you see results like this. So if you don't see results, then it means your machine is not yet installed with Node.js. So once you do that, then we are ready to move to the next step, and that is to create a file called package.json. So this is a file which is going to help us manage all the dependencies or the packages that we're going to use on the entire project. So first, we need to create a folder which is going to keep all our project files. So on my desktop, I'm going to create that folder. So new folder, and I'm going to call this folder Bootstrap minus V5 for version 5. And then I'm going to open that folder, and I'm going to open my terminal or terminal inside that project folder. So right click, open in terminal. So I'm using Git bash, and here you can see now I'm inside my project folder, and this is the path to that folder. So here I'm going to run a command which is going to initialize the process of creating that file called package.json. So that command is npm init for initialize. So this one is a step-by-step process of creating that file. So you hit enter. So here you'll see it says this utility will walk you through creating a package.json file. It only covers the most common items and tries to guess sensible defaults. So the first item here is the package name, and you can see it has already assigned the name of that folder, which is Bootstrap minus V5. That is the name of the folder that you're going to keep all our projects. So if you're not comfortable with that name, then you can type that name. For example, let's say you want a name like my project, then you can type it there and then hit enter. So for me, I'm comfortable with that name. So that is the name of that package name. And then you can also have the option to change the version. So I'm comfortable with that. Description, I'm going to write learning Bootstrap version 5 with SASS. The next item, entry point. Test command, you're going to put it later. Git repository, later. Keywords, so here you can enter as many keywords as you want, separating them with comma or space. So I'm going to start with the first keyword, which is Bootstrap space Bootstrap minus V5 space, we have SASS space learn Bootstrap space and then learn SASS. So one word. So I'm comfortable with those five keywords, actually five, and then I'm going to hit enter. Author, that should probably be your name or your company name. So I'm going to write my name, enter a license, and then here are the items you need to double check. So if you're comfortable, then you can hit enter for okay. So now we have completed that process, and now if you check inside our project folder, you'll see we have a file called package.json. The next step I'm going to do now is to install the packages that you're going to use in our project, and I'm going to start with the first package, which is .sass. .sass is going to help us compile our SASS to CSS. So you can go to this website called npmjs.com, and here you can search for that package. So on the search bar, I'm going to type .-sass. So I'm going to click on this result that says .sass, a pure JavaScript implementation of SASS. So the first thing you see here is this package has been deprecated. So it means that this package has been renamed from .sass to SASS. So on the usage, there are different ways of you installing it depending on your environment and your needs. And because you're using NPM, then you're going to install it using NPM. So here you can install it globally by using this command, that is npm install -gsass, which will provide access to the SASS executable. You can also use this other command, which you're going to add it to your project, that is npm install --savedev and then SASS. So I'm going to copy that command, and then on my terminal I'm going to paste it. So here on our project folder, you'll be able to see a folder called node modules. So it has added that package. So I'm going to open the entire folder, which is the project folder on my text editor. I'm using VS Code. So here you'll see our file called package.json. And you can see here we have the first dev dependency called SASS. So it has installed that package. And here you can see all the items that we typed. We have the name of that package, we have the keywords and description, the author, and now we have a dev dependency called SASS. So using version 1.328. So the next package you're going to install is Bootstrap. So let me show you something from the official documentation, which is getbootstrap.com. So here we have currently version 5.0, beta 3. So by the time I was doing this course, it was in beta 3. So it can be different by the time you're watching this video. So here on the installation, we have this command. So I'm going to copy this command. And then on my terminal, I'm going to paste. And then I'm going to flag it with --save. So it has added that package. So if you check from our text editor, we have a new dependency called Bootstrap, version 5, beta 3. So the next package we're going to install is Font Awesome. So let me show you something from the official documentation, which is fontawesome.com. So here we are going to click on start for free. And then down here, you need to click on NPM because you're going to install it using NPM. So here currently I'm going to use version 5.153. And then you're going to copy the command for installing using NPM. And this is the command. Copy, and then on my terminal, I'm going to paste. So it has completed. From the text editor, you can see now we have a new dependency called Font Awesome, the free version, version 5.153. So now we are ready to start working with our project, and those are dependencies are enough to start creating our project. We're going to add more as we go along the course as the need arises. The next step I'm going to do is to create an NPM script, which is going to compile my SAS files. So here on the scripts, we have a predefined script. So I'm going to remove it and then write my own. So the first item on the script is the name of the script. So we have the double quotes and then the name of that script. I'm going to call it compile SAS. And here you have the option to give it any keyword that you want. Then we have the command. So the command, you're going to start with SAS, the name of that package, which is going to compile our SAS to CSS. And here you can see we have dev dependency called SAS. And then the second item on the command is the source of your SAS files. So you have to tell the script where it's going to get your SAS files. So this one is a folder. So I'm going to create a folder called SCSS. And then we have the colon and then the destination of where you want to keep your compiled CSS. So again, we have to tell the script to create the folders where it's going to keep the compiled CSS. So we have the folder called assets and then another one called CSS. So the script is going to get my SAS files from the CSS folder and then compile it and keep it inside this folder called CSS. So we can save that and then create this folder called SCSS. So inside the project, we have that folder called SCSS. So to make sure that our script is working, I'm going to compile a SASS file, and this one is just for testing purposes. So inside the SCSS folder, and this is the folder that we said you're going to keep all the SASS file. So I'm going to create that file and I'm going to call it style.scss. So for now, you're not going to put anything on that SASS file. So I'm going to open my terminal and then run that script. So here I'm going to run npm run and then the name of that script, which is compile SASS. So I'm going to hit enter. So now you can see it has compiled and terminated or ended that process. So if you check now on our text editor, we have on our project, we have a new folder called assets. And then inside the assets, we have another folder called CSS, which has the two files. So if you check here on our project folder, you can see we have the assets folder and then CSS and then the two files. The first file is the style sheet, which has been compiled to style.css. And another one is a source map. And source maps are basically files that tell browsers or other tools that consume CSS how that CSS corresponds to the SASS files from which it was generated. So they make it possible to see and even edit your SASS files in browsers. So here we're going to put our scripts to test. So here I'm going to create a variable which is going to be compiled to CSS. So I'm going to open my style sheet to the side so that you can see it in real time. So I'm going to create a variable here called primary. And I'm going to assign a value or a hex value of FF0. And then I'm going to create a class called test, which I'm going to assign that color. So we have the color and then the which is the primary. So I'm going to save. And then on the terminal, I'm going to run that command again. So now you can see it has compiled our SASS to CSS, and this is the compiled CSS. So here we need to make sure, if you check again here on the terminal, you can see it has compiled and then terminated that process. So we need to keep this script running so that it can watch for the changes that you're going to do on our folder or on the file. So on the package.json file, you're going to modify this script and you're going to add the watch flag, so that it can watch for the changes that you're going to do every time we do the changes. So on the script, immediately after the SASS, that is the package, I'm going to create a space and then minus minus watch. So that way it will watch for the changes that you're going to do on that folder or any file that you're going to put inside the SCSS folder. So I'm going to save that. And then on my terminal, I'm going to run again that command, which is npm run compile SASS. And here on the terminal, you can see now it says SASS is watching for the changes. So again, here on the style.scss file, I'm going to add some nesting or do some nesting. First, let's add a color. I'm going to add another color and I'm going to call secondary. And here I'm going to add a value of FF000. That is a red color. And then also I'm going to do some nesting. So another class inside the test, and I'm going to call test1. I'm going to assign it that color, which is the secondary. And I'm going to save. So we'll be able to see real-time changes on our compiled CSS. You can see now we have that compiled CSS. So that is because the script is watching for the changes that you're going to do inside that folder called SCSS. And remember, we only have one file called style.scss. So that means now we are ready to start working on our project.